The choral part of the symphony is, you might think it's just people singing the Ode to Joy, but actually not very much of it is singing the Ode to Joy. Most of it is singing choral music that was new choral music, had never been written, and frankly I don't think much has been written since like this choral music. It goes to ranges in the human voice that had never been used for chorus. It uses decibel levels, three fortes, that had never been used for chorus. And it uses harmonies that never have been used for chorus or since. Very, very special, strange, sometimes harmonies. And that draws us in, like, what is that? What am I hearing here? And what are they talking about? What is the text? The text is, how come the millions of people on the face of the earth, at that time it was millions maybe in 1827, I don't know, but how come the millions of the people are not together? How come we're all trying to sing this strange music, but it doesn't sound like we're a common humanity? Don't you see that we're crashing as a race? Can't you sense the Creator's presence? That line in this piece is a pivotal moment. Can't you sense the Creator's presence? For the last 2 minutes of the symphony, what more could he do? What more could Beethoven do? He's stated the tune. It's had every possible emotional interaction with us in this hour. So the last 2 minutes go to prestissimo, which is even faster than the presto. It's the fastest music can be. And there's this, again, this repeating over and over. And the piccolo plays a really wonderful role here. The piccolo plays this flourish at the end. And she, or he, takes us to the top of the register of the human ear. It's the highest instrument. And so, The last lick of this symphony is a little piccolo lick. So everybody's going yada da 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 da, and then the piccolo goes yep, and that's the end. And it just everybody just jumps to their feet.
Thank you.